Hi everyone. Today is December 1st and it's World AIDS Day. World AIDS Day was first observed in 1988, and each year, organisations and individuals across the world bring attention to the HIV epidemic, endeavour to increase HIV awareness and knowledge, and speak out against HIV stigma. For the past 2 years, COVID-19 has raged on as a global pandemic and disrupted our daily lives. Many comparisons have been made with the HIV epidemic, and there are many lessons to be learned from it, such as the importance of prevention, equitable access, and most importantly, community mobilization through a people-centered approach. This World AIDS Day, we want to focus on hope and the future. Throughout our program today, we want to put the spotlight on stories shared by people living with HIV, our longtime volunteers, and our staff.
Hey, I'm Preeti Nair, Singapore's top doctor. For legal purposes, I'm not a real doctor lah, but I got to do my research, so I'll show you my resources. You're welcome. Today, I'm here to debunk your misconceptions about HIV and AIDS.
Nobody asked. Nobody asked. Literally nobody asked that.
So I asked you guys on Instagram what are some misconceptions you've heard about HIV and AIDS, and there were just too many. So most of these misconceptions surround the transmission of the virus, pop culture stereotypes, and about people living with HIV. So it's time to get to the facts. What is HIV and AIDS? Okay, so first things first, HIV stands for Human Immunodeficiency Virus. HIV is a retrovirus that infects the cells of the human immune system and impairs their function. Infection with this virus results in the progressive depletion of the immune system, leading to immunodeficiency. AIDS stands for Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. Infection with HIV has been established as the underlying cause of AIDS. So to explain this in layman's term, because I'm a doctor and you're not, AIDS is kind of like late-stage HIV. So it occurs when one's immune system has been badly damaged by HIV. If I get HIV, does it mean I will get AIDS? Getting HIV does not mean you will definitely get AIDS. People with HIV have started receiving antiretroviral treatment, and today HIV can be managed as a chronic condition. And people on ART usually never go on to develop AIDS. Can it spread through blank? This one, I don't know if y'all just damn creative or what, but let me just speed answer a bunch of questions about HIV transmission. Can it spread through a mosquito bite? No. What if you sit on the same chair or toilet seat? No. What about touching, huh? Handshakes, hugging, exchange saliva? No. What about through an ulcer wound, air or water contact? No. What about sharing food? No! But what if HIV patients cut their hands and then drip the blood into open chili containers in the food courts? No! Does it only spread through gay sex? Hello, hello! This one fake news, okay? This just adds to the stigma faced by gay members of the LGBTQ+ community in Singapore. So for your information, based on 2020 stats by MOH, there were 20 new female cases of HIV infections. Heterosexual HIV infections account for 38.1% of the cumulative mode of transmission.
It only spreads through sex workers.
Boo! This one also just adds to the stigma against sex workers. All regulated sex workers go through regular STI and HIV testing. Sex workers are also professionals who would typically practice safe sex, as we all should, especially if we have multiple sexual partners. And if you're all about the dangerous sex life, then all I gotta say, as your doctor, is please use protection, thank you.
You will get it if you have sex with someone who has it.
Nope. Okay, pay attention. This one very important, okay. I'm gonna explain this term that you see on screen. U equals U stands for undetectable equals to untransmittable. This means people living with HIV who are on treatment and have an undetectable level of the virus in their blood will not be able to transmit this virus to others. So, if someone has HIV, this does not necessarily mean they can transmit the virus to someone else. Bisexual men have a statistically higher chance of getting the virus and passing it on. This is why it is so important to get educated about HIV transmission, because it's really not about who you are, what you do, or what you don't do. And this is totally based off the assumption that bisexual people have more options, so they have a higher chance of getting the virus. And that is not true, because it does not take into consideration any of the other factors out there. You can't get HIV from tattoos or piercings. All professionally trained tattoo artists and piercing salons always use single-use disposable needles. So no need to worry about this one, the next time you go and pierce your nipple. If you are pregnant and HIV positive, your baby will definitely get infected with the virus. Nope, Antiretroviral drugs have almost eliminated vertical transmission of HIV. Vertical transmission means from mother to child. So a HIV-positive pregnant mom on antiretroviral drugs will not transmit the virus to their baby. So how can HIV get transmitted? All along, I tell you all the fake news other people spread about the virus transmission. So now, I'm gonna tell you how HIV can be transmitted. What is PrEP? PrEP stands for pre-exposure prophylaxis. It is highly effective in reducing the chances of contracting the HIV infection. PrEP is offered as part of a comprehensive HIV and STI prevention package. However, it does not protect you from other STIs like syphilis or gonorrhea. Where do you get PrEP, you ask? So all the information is on screen. It's time for a friendly PSA. Please don't anyhow buy medication from other people, okay? You need to have a proper prescription from a doctor. And I am not a real doctor. What is PEP? Okay, so we talked about PrEP, and that is the pre-exposure medication. But what about post-exposure? That is where PEP comes in. It is a combination of an anti-HIV medication that can prevent you from testing HIV positive if you think you have been exposed to the virus. So when does PEP come into the picture? If you had a condom fail or if you practiced unprotected sex and think you might be exposed to the virus, that means it is time to go see a doctor ASAP to get PEP. And when it comes to PEP, here's the most important thing you need to take note of. Is it safe for people living with HIV to get married and have kids? With huge advances in HIV medication and prevention options, people living with HIV can enjoy a happy married life with children, just like anyone else, without any fear of harming their partner or their child. People living with HIV or AIDS can't have fulfilling romantic or sexual lives. Once again, this is an extremely stigmatized view of people living with HIV. There are many publicly out HIV-positive celebrities who are all living very fulfilling romantic and sexual lives. And of course, here in Singapore, there are many people living with HIV who are in long-term loving relationships with HIV-uninfected persons. Is HIV criminalized in Singapore? HIV infection is not a crime in Singapore. People living with HIV are not criminals and should not be treated like criminals. They are individuals living with a chronic illness. Show recommendations. So in my Instagram Q&A box, so many of you guys sent in show recommendations, or you just wanted to really shout out some shows that helped you get informed and educated about people living with HIV. So I'm just gonna put a couple of show recommendations that you guys have sent in my DMs. I'm gonna put them all on screen so you can check it out at your own time. So before I end my consultation session with y'all, this doctor wants to give you a little PSA. I know everything I just talked about surrounding HIV and AIDS can be super daunting, and it's not an easy topic to just navigate and figure out on your own. So I really hope that this video was helpful, and I hope you guys learned as much as I learned making this video. And if you've had any fears or concerns surrounding STI or HIV testing, I just want to put it out there that there are many safe spaces you can go to. And massive shout out to Action for AIDS for doing so much important work since 1988. They're a non-governmental organization that has been dedicated to fighting AIDS and HIV infection in Singapore. It draws upon a network of healthcare professionals, advocates, educators, and volunteers to implement educational training, testing, and welfare programs. And here's the best part. All STI tests that AFA provides are completely anonymous. So it does not work like coming to see a doctor where you have to register all your information by law. So if a client tests positive on any STI test, they will be strongly advised on treatment options and to get on treatment so that they can avoid any potential spread. It will be the client's decision to break their anonymity and go to any local doctor to seek treatment. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it and learned so much from this consultation that has lasted for way too long, huh? Anyways, just kidding. I hope this video was really helpful in educating everyone on the transmission of the virus, about people living with HIV, and also brings everyone one step closer to ending the stigma. So let's all do our best with the information that we have all just been equipped with, and make sure we don't let people spread fake news all around us, okay? So none of that, and also, this clinic is closed.
Hello, A happy World AIDS Day 2021 to you. This World AIDS Day, Action for AIDS is calling for coordinated action to end HIV in Singapore by 2030. We also shine a light on the need to end economic, social and legal inequalities in society that drive HIV and other pandemics. We need policies that will protect the rights of everyone and pay attention to the disadvantaged and the marginalized who are most vulnerable. Tackling these inequalities will also advance the rights of key populations and people living with HIV. Let us commit ourselves to ending inequalities and to end HIV by 2030.
Today is World AIDS Day. It is a day to raise awareness on HIV, celebrate the tremendous biomedical advances that have been made in HIV and made possible due to community mobilization, and also remember the lives that have been lost due to AIDS. Action for AIDS Singapore has embarked on an ambitious target to end HIV in Singapore by 2030 collaboratively. Unfortunately, stigma, discrimination, marginalization and inequalities continue to pose a serious barrier to access. Today, let us all pledge to play our part to end HIV-related stigma in Singapore and to protect the rights of persons living with HIV and key populations affected by it. Only then will our vision of ending HIV in Singapore be possible. Happy World AIDS Day.
This is a story shared by Lemon, a 49-year-old person living with HIV. Love, to me, is the most important thing in my life, as since childhood, I wasn't getting attention and love by my mum and four siblings, as we have a big family and I was number three. My both parents were busy working those days, and I was feeling neglected compared to the rest of my siblings. My father passed away when I was 16. He loved me, though I lost him in my young age. So I grew up lonely. But I loved them so much. And when I started working, Whatever I earned, I gave my whole envelope to my mum for many years. The reason was that she was the one my father loved, and I wanted to take care of her on behalf of my dad, and hopefully she can love me like the rest of my siblings. When I found my better half, I felt I'm no longer alone. But unfortunately, we are HIV positive and facing stigma from people who believed HIV is a very undesirable sickness only for indecent people. In the beginning of our marriage, for the first decade, we always faced stigma, especially from my in-laws. Even though we are family, we are always being left out. We couldn't share about our situation to friends or colleagues, as we will lose them forever. We really wish people will accept who we are in the community and love us like any human being. That's all we hope for, and to not ignore us. We all want to live life simply and full of love like the rest. I always wanted to donate my organs or my blood when I am gone from this world one day. But unfortunately, my dreams won't be coming true now. We just want to be loved and care for each other. In fact, we are very normal, and we care for our health even more than normal people. So please don't abandon us from your communities. We can work like every one of you. Let us live our lives happily.
I see your monsters, I see your pain. Tell me your problems, I will chase them away. I'll be your lighthouse, I will make it okay. When I see your monsters, I will stand there so brave and chase them all the way. In the dark we stand apart, we never see that the things we need are staring right at us. You just wanna hide, never show your smile. Stand alone when you need someone, it's the hardest thing of all that you see. Are the bad memories. Take your time, you'll find me. I see your monster.
My name is Chen Xiong, and I'm an HIV doctor. And I want to tell you about U equals to U, or undetectable equals to untransmittable. Now, what this means is when people living with HIV take HIV medications, which are highly effective, what the medications do is that they stop the virus from creating more copies of itself in the bloodstream of the person living with HIV. When we then take their blood and send it off to a lab to count or to see how much virus there is in their system, it is so low that it's below the level of detection. Now, this doesn't mean that the person is cured of HIV, but this does mean that the medications are keeping the infection under control. There's no virus in the blood, and hence, the person living with HIV cannot transmit the virus on to their sexual partners or loved ones. Now, this is a real game changer in reducing HIV stigma and discrimination, because one of the major things that contributes to this is the fear that people living with HIV could transmit the virus on to others. So U equals to U, or undetectable equals to untransmittable, should really, really, really be at the forefront of all our minds, should really be something that we keep talking about to reduce HIV stigma and discrimination. Thanks so much.
This is a story shared by Ethan, a 38-year-old person living with HIV. The longest distance on Earth, it's not of its core and crust, neither highs and goodbyes, nor life and death, but hearts drifting 1,000 miles. Isn't it bewildering to be close to someone, yet his heart is never there? Isn't it surprising to be living apart of distant stars, yet the hearts seem to breathe each other? I was born into a traditional Chinese family. Our surname carries weight in the book of family names. It was said that our forefathers have predetermined the middle name for each generation to prevail family honor and prosperity. The family tree spent a fortune on morals and respects, yet skimping on the value of love. While many fortunate children grew up in fun and plays, I grew up in, well, I was played like a soccer, always on a pass and never scoring a goal, ever since 5. I spent my childhood seeking for someone that cares. I parted my adolescent years in gay clubs seeking acceptance. I medicate my 20s in recreational drugs seeking relief. I served my 30s in prison seeking redemption. I coupled my life with sex, alcohol, and drugs, SADness, and found myself married to HIV for life. I'm gay, HIV positive, and a prisoner. My family found every reason to be ashamed of me. Love was only a word I knew back then. It sounded like a chiming bell and exists only in fairy tales. Flipping through innumerable pages of stories in my bleak prison cell, I barely scratched the surface of love. Yet, it lit a glimpse of hope in my heart that it exists. I found hope in a hopeless place. I found love in a loveless place. I journey to seeking love. I kept searching for love, it never came. Love is like a butterfly. If I chase after it, it will run away. I gave up looking for love. Instead, I cared for others who are neglected and lost like me. I became a ball of joy to light up their world. When I shift my attention to others like a butterfly, love sat quietly by my side. Love is never love until it's given away. When I spread love, I truly felt what is love. I gave what I came to seek. I gave love and found love. So, what is love? Love is an indescribable feeling that's unique only to you.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear? Well, let that lonely feeling wash away. Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. It's when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh, someone will come running, and I know they'll take you home. Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you reach up and you rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. You will be found. There's a place where we don't have to feel unknown. Every time you call out, you're a little less alone. Oh, if you only say the word, from across the silence, your voice is heard. Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you reach up and you rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found. dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you reach up and you rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found.
Hi, my name is Jiayi. I'm a volunteer with Action for AIDS. I have been volunteering since 2009 when I was in poly. So I started because I had a friend who was HIV positive and I joined the organization to convince her to get help. Unfortunately, 2 years later, she passed away, but I am still volunteering because of a few reasons. So firstly, because I really believe in the cause that AFA is fighting for. Secondly, I think that a lot more work needs to be done to eradicate the stigma that surrounds HIV. And lastly, because through AFA, I've really met and made a lot of good friends and are very close with them. This is not something that you can get anywhere else. Yeah. So throughout the maybe last 10 years or more with AFA, I've taken on a few roles as a volunteer. So one would be facilitating the Revive Support Group, which is a support group for people who are newly diagnosed with HIV. I've also counseled, prayed, drew blood within the clinic. Yeah, so I think I've accumulated a lot of memorable experiences, but I guess one of it would be the very first time I had to give a positive result. So a positive result is telling a client that basically he has tested positive for HIV. And the very first time that I had to do it, because I was much younger than I am now, I had to really control the emotions that I was feeling, because in just a few seconds, I basically watched the world crash for this person. Yeah, and it was very, very hard for me to do that. Yeah, I've gotten better now, but it still affects me. But for that particular case, I actually kept in touch with him even after he left the clinic. Through AFA staff lah. Yeah, so with permission, I got his we exchanged contacts, and I kept in touch with him as he was getting help from AFA, as he was seeking treatment and all that. And I'm happy to say that now we are like very good friends, and he is undetectable, which also means that he's untransmissible. Yeah, so that was something that was really memorable for me. And I think this is the case for anyone who is able to get past that first diagnosis and seek treatment and stick to their treatment. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, hello Yang. So how do you start volunteering with us?
Well, actually I joined in 2018, but I had known AFA for a very long time because I was a customer or a client. And I always thought very well and highly of the organization. So when I left the job, pressure cooker job in the city in 2018, I thought it would be good, and I was keen to join AFA.
That's good. So why do you want to volunteer for the HIV cause?
For the HIV cause? Well, HIV has had a very severe, very big imprint on my adult life. Actually, when I was 20 years old and I had finally accepted my sexuality, that was exactly the year when there was rumors of a gay cancer, and nobody knew where it came from or how it could be cured. The next two decades for me were quite terrible, because I saw very close friends of mine become sick. And I must say, I lived in fear for my health, fear for my for the stigma that had developed, it really affected my emotional relationships as well. So in a way, I really started hating this virus as much as anybody who was directly impacted, and I think it's a very good cause to work towards the complete destruction of it.
So why are you still volunteering after all these years?
I don't think this is a short-term job. Actually, I think if everybody, all the volunteers that have worked on the HIV pulse did it for a short-term basis, then we would still be at square one. I still think that there is a lot of fear in the society. I still think there is a lot of stigma. So therefore, I think it's important to keep on educating people, providing information, and talk about it. So I don't think my task is finished yet.
So do you have any memorable stories?
There's so many memorable stories. I can't really recall one particular. Everybody that comes in this door has a very memorable story that he can tell me. The only good memories I have is the big smile when people get their non-reactive result and then they just cheekily leave this van and say, okay, see you later, alligator. Well, after grabbing a few condoms. So that really keeps me going. I think that's the most memorable thing.
Hi, I'm Hui Min and I work for AFA's mobile testing service.
Hi, I'm Jing. I work for AFA's ATS service, which stands for Anonymous Testing Service.
So the mobile testing service is a mobile clinic that is across the island, and we usually run about 2 to 3 days a week.
Our testing service is at a fixed location, which is at 31 Kelantan Link.
So do you have any interesting stories to share?
Yeah, we have quite a lot of interesting story because usually when the clients come to test, we will talk to them before and after the test. And then they tend to be very anxious and nervous before the test result comes out. And after the test result, they will always have this sense of relief, which is really good because, you know, we want people to know their HIV status so they don't need to have unnecessary worries.
Yeah, so for the mobile testing, there will be a lot of heterosexual men that come on site to get tested. And I agree with the sense of relief as well when they get after the test. But before the test, they don't have that much sexual health knowledge. But when they leave the MTS, they gain the sexual health knowledge as well. And they gain the sense of relief after getting the negative result, which is very good to see.
Yes, absolutely, yeah. So a lot of our work is actually education and spreading the right knowledge and a message as well. So just to let everyone know that as the holiday is approaching, please remember to do your annual routine screening. If you have concerns about HIV or STI, you can visit our testing site. Throughout December, we will offer free HIV testing. And just drop by and then now. It's a very simple process and then you can get your result in 20 minutes.
This is a story shared by Nithya, a 50-year-old person living with HIV. I got to know my husband more than 20 years ago and have been married ever since. After 10 years of marriage where everything is fine, my husband started to get sick very often. I was also not feeling healthy. I do not know what happened to my health. One day my husband went to the hospital and the doctor ordered him to do a blood test and the result was positive for HIV. After that I went to do my blood test and the results came out positive too. I was shocked at first, but I thought of him because I love him so much and tried to control my anger and emotion. I find myself very lucky that my baby is healthy and safe. A few months later my husband confessed about his past. Before he married me, he used to fool around with a lot of women. In the end, he was infected with HIV without his knowledge from unprotected sex. I was very angry and could not forgive him. But I did, because I love him and I love my children, and I don't want the family to have problems. We are still together to this day and take care of each other in times of illness. It's the best way that I can do. It is very important to go and see our doctor for follow-ups and take medications on time to prevent any relapse. We will be able to live like a normal person, even if we are weak. My hope? that one day there will be a cure for our disease. I want to thank my sisters and friends for their support and help whenever I needed love and encouragement. I'm given a listening ear for things that I cannot tell the world. There are people who can listen to me with understanding and without judgment. It has given me great encouragement to live happily. Thank you for listening to my story, and hopefully my story will be helpful to others.
Hi, my name is Kelvin. I am 25 years old this year. I've been living HIV for 6 years. I'm here to share with you my lived experience as a person living HIV, because our lived experience is usually a sad, traumatic, and a painful one. I'm here to show my support to those sharing my condition and to tell you that you are not alone in this.
Hi, my name is Adrian. I'm 30 years old. I've been living with HIV for about 5 years now. So as we enter the third year with COVID-19, we are also entering the fifth decade of the AIDS pandemic. I wouldn't be where I am today without the love and support from my colleagues at AFA, family members and loved ones. Love to me is to be able to be loved and loved by anyone regardless of sexual orientation, HIV status and gender identities.
Hi everyone, I'm talking to you from my living room on a beautiful Singapore morning. Today we commemorate a very important day. It's World AIDS Day. It's been 40 years since the first HIV cases were reported in this world. And since then, we've had so many conversations around inclusivity, diversity, equity. I don't think we can afford to be selective. Persons living with HIV deserve our respect. They deserve our support. They deserve to have a voice. I also believe that the best sex is safe sex. So if you need to, go get tested. It's good to know your status and know how to make plans for your life. And for the month of December, it's free at AFA. And as always, it's anonymous. To all persons living with HIV, you have my deep admiration, respect, and support. Always an ally here, and all my love.
你好，我是孙燕姿。今天是世界艾滋病日，在这里要向所有的艾滋病患者发送爱与支持，加油！我也想鼓励大家定期的接受 HIV 的检测，请不要为此而感到羞耻。在十二月份，艾滋病行动小组也会提供免费和匿名的检测，记得和你的朋友一起去。
Hello, it's Chua Enlai. Today is World AIDS Day. It's been 40 years since HIV was first reported in the United States. Let's continue to send love and support to people living with HIV. Go get tested, know your status, and to find out more about free and anonymous HIV testing taking place in December,Go to www.afa.org.sg to find out more.
The Nukalelims, that's us. Welcome to the Nukalelim Social Club.
Hi, I'm Neo Swee Lin.
I'm Lim Kay Siu.
And with our ukuleles, we're the
Nukalelims.
On behalf of the Nukalelims and all our community in the Nukalelim Social Club, we want to wish everyone living with HIV big love today. Yes. On World AIDS Day.
Yes, it's World AIDS Day, and we, you know, we have so many friends that we love so much who are people living with AIDS, and we really wish that the stigma of AIDS will disappear from the world.
We want you to know that you're not alone, and we are going to also work to make sure that this happens.
Yes.
Love will conquer all.
Love will conquer all.
Hi guys, this is Irene Ang, and today is World AIDS Day, and 40 years ago, the first case was reported in the US. I hope that those of you living with HIV will stay strong, take your medications, and exercise a lot, drink a lot of water, and be positive, okay? And for the rest of you, please always, always, always practice safe sex, use condoms, stick to one partner, you know the drill, yeah? And the most important thing is to get tested. There's a free testing that is given, so you can go on to www.afa.org.sg. God bless every one of you, and Merry Christmas.
Hi, I'm Pretty Please, Singapore's top doctor. This World AIDS Day, I want to send my love to people living with HIV, and I'm going to do my best to help break the stigma and educate everyone around me with all the information that I'm equipped with. So I also want to shout out Action for AIDS for doing such important work. So if you've ever wanted to get tested, just know that it is a safe space that really respects anonymity. So go there, get tested if that's what you want to do. And remember that early detection is always best, so you can take care of yourself and get on any treatment that you potentially need. All the best, stay safe, and take care everyone. Sending you all my love.
Hi, this is Adrian Pang from Pangdemonium Theatre Company. Today is World AIDS Day, marking 40 years since the first HIV case was reported in the United States. So I'm just taking this opportunity to wish everybody lots of love, to encourage everyone to have safe sex and to get tested. There's no shame in it. I myself have gotten tested a long time ago. And in fact, in the month of December, you can get a free and anonymous test at AFA. Find out more information at afa.org.sg and get tested now. Lots of love. Stay safe.
I'm Patricia Mok. It's World AIDS Day, and I want to send out all my love and support to people living with HIV. And for those of you who want to know about your status, just go for a free and anonymous HIV test. For more information, you can go to www.afa.org.sg. And before I sign off, always remember to have safe sex.
Hi everyone, happy World AIDS Day! Victoria Wondersnatch here, and I'd like to invite everyone to join in AFA in its mission to end HIV and AIDS by 2030 in Singapore. We can do this by several ways. One is to make sure that everyone gets tested, okay, early and treated early, because undetectable is untransmittable. And with the use of PrEP, we can make sure that we do not transmit HIV and eradicate it in Singapore. We also need to reduce stigma and discrimination of people living with HIV and the queer community. We can do this by increasing positive representation of LGBT individuals in the media, and also through art and storytelling, and to increase empathy in our general population. And if we do all this, we can have a much more inclusive and empathetic society here in Singapore, and to end HIV by 2030. I'm Victoria Wondersnatch, and I approve this message. Bye.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Today is World AIDS Day. It has been 40 years since HIV has been detected in the United States, so I'm sending my love and support to anybody who has HIV. Now, if you don't know what your status is, go get tested. You can get tested for free in the month of December through the Action for AIDS organization. It is anonymous. It is free. Go get tested. That's what you should do. Peace out. Send in love.
I see your monsters. I see your pain. Tell me your problems, I will chase them away. I'll be your lighthouse, I will make it okay. When I see your monsters, I will stand there so brave and chase them all the way. In the dark, we stand apart, we